how the toxic power of hate can propel deadly violence. At the same time, we saw the almost unimaginable capacity of humans to interrupt hate with selfless love. That is who we truly are. We come together as individuals with our own voices and our own stories to make the community and the home that we want. That ideal can be threatened by racism, violence, and hate. We must hold together and support each other in order to build a community that is more fair, just, and safe. It may sometimes seem like it's one tragic story after another, and when it happens in our own community, it hurts even more. It's important that we also take care of ourselves and ensure that we are there for those who need our help. If you or someone you know needs support, the Multnomah County Crisis Line is available. The Crisis Line can be reached at 503-988-4888. It is operated by our mental health staff every day, every hour. Never hesitate to call. Thank you to the veterans here for organizing this event and for your commitment and your service to our community. Thank you to the veterans who work for Multnomah County every day, continuing in their careers of public service. We could not do our work without you. We could not serve the community with the excellence that we do without your power and your service. So with that, thank you for honoring me and allowing me to be here with you. And now, please,
thank
take
you.
It away.
Appreciate that very much.
Of course.
Thank you very, very much for being with us today. I think it's a day that all of us, as far as I'm concerned, we tend to pay tribute on an annual basis. It's called Memorial Day. And it's so interesting that this event really will happen during that particular period of time. So in many ways, we've not closed the door yet on Memorial Day as a result of what happened here in our city, in our county. And just to pay tribute to that and let all of us know, besides just being here in the state of Oregon, but around the country, because we're pretty well known around the country what happened here. And we just, again, like many of us celebrate Memorial Day and people are still hurting and whatever. So we figured by doing this, we can basically maybe close the book a bit and then we can just move on. But it's a very painful period at this point in time, because our brothers and sisters died, if you will, for this country. What we're going to do here now is that I'm going to let each one of these guys introduce themselves, identify the services that they participated in, and we'll just go from there. And then after we do that, hopefully we'll just have them, each one of us can just start kind of talking a little bit about how they felt about Memorial Day, if you will, and their services and whatever they want to say. And then we'll even open it up for questions for you out there sitting out there up front. That's fair? Okay, but then why don't we start off with you, Joe?
Me?
Joe. Joe's going to go first.
Hi, for those who don't know me, my name is Joe Walsh. I served in the United States Navy from 1962 to 1971, most of the Vietnam War, about 9 years. And then I objected to the war and then was given an honorable discharge. We had some interesting times in my last year of the Navy. I think we are very different here at this podium, but we all share the pain of these honorable people that were sitting on a train not knowing each other. And somebody said some really nasty things to two young girls. And they got up, all three of them, not knowing each other, and said, "No, that's the greatest thing about Americans. We do stand up and say, no. You can't do that. Mussolini. You can't do that, Mr. Hitler. You cannot do that, Mr. Stalin. We will not allow you to do it. And we fight. And we come and we fight. And we say to our politicians, no, you can't do that. And we fight. And these three wonderful people told them they'd their lives, and the other one almost did. And it was the height, that moment. It was the height of all glory as a nation, as a people. It is the best of us. We've all seen the worst, but we are the best also. When I heard the news, and I was almost instantly notified on the internet, I didn't know what to say, I didn't know what to do. Here's this, these two wonderful human beings, one worked for the city of Portland. He was 52, I'm 75, that means he had another 25, 30 years to live. If he reached my age. And the other one was 26. He just graduated college, but he was willing to give his life. How proud we should be on that. I mean, we should walk on water just thinking about them. You know, I mean, of all the things that I've done in my life, nothing compared to that. I mean, to stand up and watch somebody with a knife come after me. I mean, I grew up in Brooklyn, New York, so, I mean, attacks are not unusual for me. I mean, I'm used to that. But to have someone with a big knife come up, we as veterans should be very proud. You know, we do a lot of things wrong in this country, but we should be proud of this moment. And that's what we did. We asked that the flag be flown at half mast. And Bruce, you're absolutely right. The only two people that I know of can do it is the president and the governor. I thought the mayor could do it, but he doesn't have the authority to do it. Only the president and the governor. So a lot of us went to the mayors and went to our elected officials and say, lower the flag. These are our heroes. This is my hero. And we ran into some trouble, you know, some hesitation. And we said, no, you cannot do that. And the flag's being lowered. That's what's great about our country. You know, even when we're mad at each other, even when I walk out of this room so angry sometimes, I turn around and I look at five women sitting here who are elected officials, and I smile, even in my anger. We do a pretty good job from time to time. And these guys are the example. You know, if they're the heaven, they're in heaven, man. You know? And they're probably watching what we do now. So maybe when we get up in the morning, we should look in the mirror just a little bit and say, maybe I should be better today, more patience. That's the word that I'm trying to work with. It's not working so good with me lately. But I like to work on that word. And maybe if I think about them, they will help me with a little bit of patience. And I'll smile instead of really getting angry one of these days at a politician. So that's me. I'm sorry.
That's what I'm doing. You did fine. Yeah. You did fine. No problem.
Okay. It's all yours.
My name is Keith Fitch. I'm in the Marine Corps, 50 to 53, during Korea. I didn't go to Korea, but put in for Korea three times, but they, for some reason, they didn't want me to go. And probably because I didn't like the cold, and it's really cold over there. Anyway, thank you. Oh, and I want to say, I want to I want to salute both of the gentlemen that, that gave their lives for the cause. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Keith.
I'm Don Dupay. I was in the U.S. Navy a long time ago, back in the Cold War. I was on active duty from 1956 to 1959, certainly before most of you were born. Back in those days, there were no satellites, there were no computers to speak of, so it was an entirely different military.
My name is Craig Murphy. I was with the U.S. Coast Guard from 1979 to 1988. During that time, I was given the opportunity to save people's lives, and some people call us heroes. I feel that these three people that stood up against hate were true heroes, and I'm honored to be here.
Okay. I'm Bruce Broussard, and I served in the Marine Corps over 10 years, and I was a helicopter ground instructor. Stationed in Vietnam for 2 years, and from Tet, I got out, came back, and then I was assigned to Portland, Oregon as a Marine recruiter. That was a very interesting time. And I can still remember the days that I got, when we got off the plane, when I got back from Vietnam, people were spitting on us. And I still get a little tight with that. Suicide, PTSD, hung himself. And that was hard to take, and I still feel strong about it. But, just like Don, kind of like you start thinking about things like that. But that's what I thought when these guys got slashed, and especially the person that was in the military. I mean, I know what he went through, scan. Come back home and to face this issue. But even the individual who did a horrific event aspect of it, the first thing that came to mind, because I'm sort of like in killers myself, I haven't known some of the events that have been happening in town. And I knew this guy. And I was always asking the question, what about the mentally illness that we have here on the streets? Why was it being taken care of? I can still remember asking the Portland police, what's the problem? Well, you know, hey, he can do what he wants to do, you know, it's general interest. Well, he can't be running around making statements like niggas and this, that, and the other. It's disrupting a lot of folks. Why can't you put him in the car and take him to the hospital? But I still remember when they pulled damage here. I still remember that day. They had a facility here to take care of these folks. So that's another reason why I'm doing this, because I want to talk about some of the issues that are sitting on the table that got us to this particular point. A lot of these folks are out there, they need help. And we don't have a place for them to go. All we do is give them 4 or 5 pills or something like that, and put them out in the street. And they have nowhere to go. And we've got to do something. Otherwise, this is going to happen more, over and over and over. And that's why I make that point about the fact that I'm still in Nam, I'm in Vietnam. And I just far as he's concerned, and his name Joe Zinn, we asked everybody just to identify. Just Lord, if I hate. I've been doing this for about 2-3 weeks. Even when I was in the process of talking to people about Memorial Day and trying to educate folks on my talk show, wearing my gear and telling people about what that all meant and how these guys went and coming back and fought and died, if you will, so that everybody here could be free and say what you want to say. It meant this whole nine yards. But at some point in time, it doesn't even make sense. And people need to know that. What this country's all about, and what these folks are sacrificing, they're still sacrificing, they're still going through these issues with their loved ones and the like. To me, he was a brother. So I can give you more stories, but the fact of the matter is that we've got a lot of work to do with reference to understanding who we are and what we represent as folks who have spent their time and paid their lives. This country could be what it's all about. It's not an easy task. We need to understand what it's all about. Things have changed a little bit because people say, well, thanks for serving. That's good, but we got to go beyond that. I'm still suffering. I go to VA every Thursday, just sitting around with other vets, just talking about our stories, trying to take us through this, I promise. And every week, we hear stories. And that's the thing that's keeping me going today. So, I think I've said a lot. But I want to thank all of you for being here and hopefully you will to share this as the old Facebook says, you know, share and comment. Hopefully you can share some of the things that were said by some of these guys. And what we'll do now is that we'll just kind of open it up. See if anybody has any questions or anything, anybody, any of the vets want to say anything else? Please, there's a gentleman right here, Eric, I met Eric on the phone, and he's here now today, and he gave us a little medallion right here, and I think he's a very interesting guy, so I'd like for him right up front, we just talk about some of the things that you're doing here in Multnomah County. I think it'd be a great deal. Come on, Eric, come on up here. Come on, sit up here by the vets.
Sit up, okay. First off, thank you, everyone, for joining us today. And I do want to thank you, gentlemen, first and foremost, for your service. I mean, it's something we say, I think it's something we absolutely honor throughout the county and throughout the state. This is something that we feel very thankful for everyone who served. It's part of our moniker. It's for all who served. But also, just thank you all for escalating this issue and honoring those fallen, particularly our veteran, and holding all of them in memoriam. And it's always pleasing to see Multnomah County as a whole come together to demonstrate that unity and seeing everyone in our community as one and speaking out against atrocities that we see. Fantastic. I get just as emotional just hearing your stories, and it's something that's dragged me into public service. My staff here, most of my staff here, who every day along with our county staff are representing veterans and their families and making sure there's equitable access so that people have information, but also making sure there's social justice first and foremost.
Thank you. Appreciate that very much. Okay, come on, yes, come on. Talk, say something. Anybody want to say something? This is the guy getting ready to enlist in the Marine Corps.
I've already done my time. But my name is Joshua Davis, and I am a volunteer at Multnomah County Veterans Services and a combat veteran from the Iraq War. And as much as we have seen barriers come to the forefront of media for veterans today, it's just a drop in the bucket compared to what you fine gentlemen have had to endure over the course of your time in military service and the post service. So as a veteran myself, yes, I am thankful for your service, but I'm more thankful for your sacrifice. And that sacrifice continues through your mentorship and the leadership skills that all of you service members possess, that myself as a young veteran, I would be remiss if I didn't try to spend as much time as I can under your learning trees. So thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you for everything.
Thank you very much. Appreciate that very much. Someone else comments?
I have to piggyback on what Josh said. My name is Hannah Potter. I'm with Multnomah County Veteran Services, and I'm the CMA there, so I answer the phone. But I also have to say thank you. I'm a veteran myself, but hearing the phone calls coming in from veterans of your era, if it weren't for you guys, us younger vets wouldn't have the benefits we have. Because you guys endured what makes me emotional too, hearing you guys' story. What you guys endured when you came home, and to persevere and still apply for the benefits, is what opened the door for a lot of us today. VA still has a lot of work to do, as we know. But I have to say, I'm very grateful for those sacrifices and for that perseverance. As well as honoring the veteran we lost last week. I'm not sure if you guys are aware, but the survivor, he survived because of another veteran.
Yeah, another veteran, right? Vancouver.
Army
right?
Veteran.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Jumped right in. So thank you for your guys' service as well.
You know, I might add to it this time, just talking a little bit more about what Joel was saying in regards to this horrific event. It was not all in one. Everything was at the table. We had a diversity situation there. We had a Muslim. We had an African American. We just had a regular student just graduate, whatever. We had a family member who happened to be a vet. And these are all these things that have divided us quite a bit among us. And we just went to work hard to get together. I can remember when I met this guy, and he was the one that got me to go to the VA for my PTSD. I thought he was kidding. And because I said, no way I was going to go to the VA. He was just carried with me. I went through my first family. I didn't know why. And but had it not been him, I wouldn't have known anything. And as a result of that, I met Don. Him to go.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden he got involved in a situation in which he needed those services too. And so now as a result, Keith is there. Yeah, he's Keith over there, Marine Corps. He too has did the same thing. So now we're doing a kind of a no vet left behind. So we're going to be reaching out. We're going to be visiting all of these services that are outside of the VA and vetting them. Because a lot of people just basically putting up their shingles and saying, identify with the vets. Well, you got some hard charges right here, trust me. Joe doesn't know this yet, but he's going to be part of the team too. But we're just going to be going around to those varying organizations to find out whether or not, in fact, they're doing the job. You know, we need to do that. This is not, sure, these are good times right now. People are saying, thanks for serving. But we got to work. We got to work at making sure that it's doing what it's supposed to do. Because in many cases, you're paying for it. You're paying for it. But there's still a lot of need, a lot of folks. We know a lot of vets are still out there that haven't gone in. And a lot of vets don't want to talk to anybody but vets. That's the other thing a lot of people don't know. A lot of people don't know that I shared my story with you because this is part of my therapy. Mm-hmm. There's nothing wrong with you shed a few tears. Nothing wrong with that. It took a long time for me to relate to my son. Because had I known what I know today about vets, he wouldn't have hung himself. Because he had the same problem that I had. So I suffer with that right now because I feel I blame myself. But I'm going to get through this.
PTSD is real as hell. And if you want to see the truth across the board, go to the vets hospital. Sit in the lobby, watch these old, worn out,
One of the things that